It's been 5 years since Gavin Wood launched the Polkadot project, a paradigm-shifting effort to create a scalable and interoperable platform that uses a novel concept called parachains. Teams all around the world will be competing in auctions for a chance at winning a coveted parachain slot. Those auctions start today. My name is Brian Hoffman, and I'm the crypto platform product lead at Kraken. And on this show, you'll hear from leaders and innovators building parachains on Polkadot and its sister project, Kusama. Whether this is the first you've heard of parachains, or you're a DeFi aficionado, come with us behind the scenes as we explore the technology of the future today. Last few weeks, I've had the chance to interview engineers, entrepreneurs, and founders from projects preparing to unleash their unique blockchain vision and finally see their hard work pay off as the first parachains go live. Here's a quick look at what you can expect as we learn more about Kusama and Polkadot on the Parachain Auctions podcast.
First parachain auction ever. So we actually, we don't know what to expect. We're just going to kind of wait and see what happens. In the Kusama fashion, expecting chaos.
A lot of these other alternative layer one blockchains are trying to winner takes all kind of approach to everything. And they don't really think of it conceptually as like, well, we want to play nice with all these other chains. Like, because personally, and I don't know how you feel, probably agree based on what you're doing, you know, this world is going to be multi-chain. Back in 2017 is the ICO stuff that kind of hit, and a lot of people invested in those projects, like not really understanding what was going on because they were basically templated tokens that were just, you know, built from the spec. But I think when you dig into some of the projects, like what you guys are working on, there's just so much more to it. There's just so many more engineering challenges and depth of engineering that I think people will be really, really surprised to see when these things go live, how like powerful they can be.
And this auction is what's called a unpermissioned candle auction. And it's actually modeled after an auction that used to happen, I think in the 1600s or so with boats. And they would light a candle. And then as soon as the candle went out, the auction would end. So you would never know exactly when the final bid would be. So the team at the Web3 Foundation modeled the auction in the same way so that you wouldn't have what some people may have seen on eBay, where people come in and snipe at the last second and try to win at the very last second with a high bid. With this candle auction, what happens is on Kusama, this will be a 7-day period. The first 2 days will be kind of an opening period. And then the 5 final days will be what's called an ending period, where the winner could actually be randomly chosen at any moment. But you won't know that winner until the end of day 7. So what that does is, for teams like us, we want to be winning at all times during the 5-day ending period, because we never know when that winner is going to be chosen. So you're going to be making bids as the auction goes along. But as a team, you have 2 ways of actually bidding. The first way of bidding is to bid with just the single account that you as the team own. Maybe there's a team that has a lot of KSM and they just decide to bid on their own. The other option is to use what is actually the module within the Substrate framework is actually called the crowd loan module.
It can make it a little stressful if you're a project, because you need to, you know, you don't have a shoe-in kind of guarantee to like be in one of these spots. But I think, you know, that's, you know, we understand the logic and support it. Now, as we're kind of heading into, you know, some of these first slots being made available on Kusama, you know, we do see, obviously, you know, ourselves and a lot of other folks are kind of gearing up, you know, efforts to, you know, occupy one of these slots. We, along with many other teams, are and our foundation are pursuing this idea of a crowd loan. So a crowd loan is a way that you can, you know, kind of get your community to help support you as a project, like into occupying like one of these initial slots. And so, yeah, I think that pretty much many of the, if not most, almost all of the teams that I've, you know, talked to, you know, we have, you know, obviously good kind of relationships with a lot of these teams working in the same ecosystem, are kind of planning on one of these crowd loans. And yeah, I think it's just a cool idea that Parity came up with to kind of have this ability for the community to kind of express itself, right? You know, on who they think, you know, the projects should be that are occupying these scarce resources, like on the relay chain. And we obviously want to be one of those projects that occupy like one of these initial, you know, there's an initial five slots.
And you guys have an interesting approach as well to how you want to roll out your software project onto these chains, right? So maybe you could give us just a little bit of an outline of like your roadmap, like where you've come from so far in this mission, and like how did you get, you know, how do you plan to get to what eventually become Hydra on the Polkadot chain?
Even though we were not insiders, right? We're pretty much the outsiders of the Polkadot ecosystem. So we were not like famous founders or, you know, personas from the ecosystem. We started really at the edge, sort of, but we still had that ambition. We weren't really sure how, you know, the Kusama Polkadot relationship will work, like at the very beginning, because like it wasn't really clear. But as we saw that Kusama is becoming its own thing, like it's not only like this site thing, but it's its own thing, right? It's not a testnet, but it's not really a testnet. It's a real value, right? And some people did not really believe that Kusama can be valuable, but if you look at, you know, I mean not only price wise, but in terms of the community and the projects that are there, and not just because they can test their things, but because they can play with real world value. And Kusama has become it has its own people, it has its own kind of vision that I think it's complementary to Polkadot.
Awesome, great. And there's always one final thing we do on this podcast at the end. So the official slogan of Kusama is to expect chaos. So we ask all of our guests to give us a chaos score, 0 to 10. How chaotic do you think this is going to be?
That's a good question. I mean, 0 to 10. I would put it at least at 5.
Okay, give us a score for this moment in time. What? Right today? What is it? Is it an 8 or a 9? What is it? Come on,
we gotta knock it down. I give it an eight.
Okay, an eight. All right.
I don't want to give it a 10 because that means we are at the limit. But I think we can still go.
You're giving yourself room for more chaos. Okay.
Yes.
That's fair. We'll take it. Okay. Make sure you like, subscribe, and review us on your favorite podcast platform, and we'll be sure to bring you along as we get a backstage pass to the world of Parachain Auctions. Remember, you can learn more about all things crypto by going to kraken.com/learn. And until next time, I'm Brian Hoffman, and this has been the Parachain Auctions podcast. The possibilities are endless.
Content is not financial or investment advice. All interviews and discussions are opinions only. Kraken does not endorse the accuracy of this content. None of the following information should be construed as a recommendation to support any specific Parachain project or to participate in Parachain auctions in general. See our terms of service for more information.